I give an example. Could you blow the shofar on Shabbat?
No.
No. If Rosh Hashanah fell on Shabbat, right? Do you blow the shofar? No. According to the Torah, you should. Came the rabbi and said, no more blowing shofar on Shabbat. Rabbi, what are you doing? You're taking away the mitzvah. Right? But if this mitzvah could bring more averot to carry Rosh Tarabim and the averot, the rabbi has the power to cancel a mitzvah, b'shev al tasim, which means don't do it. Here also, you're right, it's a mitzvah to accept gerim. But if by accepting them, more damage will come, right? Will destroy, it's better to cancel this mitzvah. The rabbi have the power, the same way they stop blowing shofar on Shabbat, they could stop kavod if more bad will come than good from this mitzvah. And that's mutar. And that's not called canceling mitzvah forever, because eventually, when Mashiach will come, this mitzvah will come
back. Well, either way, now that they have, they can go through the back door, they can go to the Ashkenazim, so.
Do what you want, but I don't want to be the one that step on your nonsense. Right, and indeed they said, look in Ashkenazim.
So the Ashkenazim must be diluted like
of course, look around. We don't have bias. Look what happened with Goyim, with Reform, right? Whatever they were Reformed, most of them are married with Goyim Goyot. Right? Why? Because they convert for $2.99, he goes Goy, he comes back outside, he's a Jew, right? Right? He takes two sprinkles, tick, Shalom Eichel, say Shema Yisrael, you have a Jew, Hashem Yishmo. Don't laugh, these people like this. By us, because they stop this thing, we don't have so much gloom in our look around. Do you know anyone whose kids are going?
No, I haven't.
Go around. Do you know anyone whose grandchildren are going in our community? Almost none. Even if it's not religious, no one has grandchildren going. You go to Reform.
No, I know a bunch of cases that they're you know, that there's something wrong.
But they know that when they do it, it's one in a thousand. Lo alech noyim by Ashkenazim. They have this Reform that kid destroy.
The kids are always have to pay the price at the end.
So right. So therefore, the rabbi.
The ones I'm thinking of.
So very good. Don't say them.
No, I'm not saying names. So they have to pay a lot of money to even find a guy to take a free house for their daughter, whatever it may be.
Really.
Yeah, happens all the time.
But again, but this is what it is. Our rabbi in the community said, listen, bad is going to come from it, although it's a mitzvah. Sometimes it's preferable to stop doing a mitzvah if that mitzvah will be the cause of a lot of bad things. And you are allowed to do it. So that's the answer. The answer is, don't get married with convert. Rabbi was telling because he was a Kohen. He was telling his kid with Kohanim. The second answer, he was telling his children because they were the kids of Kohanim. Now we're coming to the final answer. I mean, third one. Final veka de amri aramit mamash. Do not sit on a bed of a goya. You shouldn't sit on a bed of a goya. Why not? Umishum ma'aseh de Rav Papa. Because the story of Rav Papa. What happened with Rav Papa? Rav Papa, one time, he was called by a goya to come to his house. He came, he had a report, she was in a pool in the society, whatever. He came over, she opened the bag, said, Rabbi, please take a seat. I'll bring you coffee, whatever you want. Take a seat. He said, no. I'm not sitting on this bed until you pick it up. Let me see what's under the bed. They pick up the bed, oh, what was under?
A dead child,
a dead baby. What happened? They wanted to go blame Rabbi Papa that he killed the child. So what they did, they put the dead child under the bed, they told him to sit, he said, I'm not sitting under this bed until you pick it up. So he never trust Goyim, you're right. By him was a bed. But the lesson you have to take from it is, do not trust a Goya. You have to ask whatever it is, do not trust them. They always have something in the back of the mind to destroy you. And this is what it says. The Rav Papa said, Gaber Ramit, he went to visit Goya. She took out the bed. She said, please, tfotal, sit down, take a seat. Amala, any Hoshev, I will not sit down on this bed. I pick up the bed first. She picked it up. She found a dead baby. Mikan Amu, for me, we learn, it's forbidden to sit on the bed of a Goya. Now, let me explain what really happened there. Here, there's an explanation on the side of Pirush, Rabbi Nisim Gaon. He said, Chidush. He said, Maase, what happened over there? Maase, Shaya le Rav Papa, Aita lo Malve, Itzel Goy. Amar, Kevan, Shedako Rav Papa le Goy, Be Malve, Shelo, Ratsa Goy, Lassot lo Alila. Rav Papa lend money to a Goy. Now, this Goy didn't know how to pay him back. So what did the Goy did? Right? What the guy did? He killed the baby. He put a dead baby under the bed. He went to call Rav Papa over. Tell Rav Papa to sit on the bed. Go around, tell the authorities, the police, look, Rav Papa killed the baby. Once he's in jail, I don't have to pay any more the money. Yes. That was our plan. Right? So never trust goyim. You can never trust. Right? You never know what, even in business. You might think the Esav Sone Israel. Nothing to talk about. Goyim, they hate you. Whatever you are, you think, he's my partner for 20 years, any moment, he could have Shalom go against you. So here also, the goyim, they went to kill the baby. They put the baby under. Why? To be safe from paying back. And Papa he went inside. He looked at the bed, see something is weird here. Something with wisdom. I'm not sitting on this bed. And for me, we learn it's forbidden to sit on the what is called on the bed of Aramit because of this story. Now let's the last case. The Al Tavor Bet HaKnesset. We said you shouldn't pass by next to Bet HaKnesset. The rabbi explained, Beshaash Atzibur Mitpalelim. When the congregation, the shul, is praying, do not pass by the shul. Why? Because they're praying. Are you passing by with your car, right, smoking your cigar? Say, look, is that coming to the shul? And look like he, look, Chad v'Shalom, Yach Kofer, in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. The whole shul is praying to Hashem, and you're passing by and going the other way, that show, you don't believe in Hashem, Chad v'Shalom. You're not coming to pray. Therefore, don't pass by the shul when you know they're praying. Number one, you should go to the shul anyway to pray. You should go. If you don't go, don't pass in front of it at the time they pray, because what people, I might tell you, who cares what people say? Who cares? We know the Inyan of Ve'itim Nekiim Me'Hashem U'Mi'Yisrael. We have to be clean in the eyes of Hashem, of God, and of Bnei Yisrael. Which means you have to do things, be careful that people will not speak bad about you. Example, you have a cup of milk, right? And you're eating hot dogs, and it's soy milk, and people might think you're eating basar bechalav. Something you should put a sign here, it's a parve. Right, you don't want people to say about you, look, he's eating basar bechalav. You might, who cares? So we explain once. People will look at you and say, this guy is a rasha. Whatever this come out of their mouth will have an impact on you. Right? But it's not true, you're right. But when they say those words, these words go to Shammai, and the me'orer, mekatregim, say, look, somebody is a rasha. And then the courts will start looking to you. So you don't want that. That's why Ve'item Nekiim, Me'ashiv, we have to make sure that Hashem look at you nicely, and also people around you. Therefore, when they're praying in the shul, don't pass by at the time with the praying if you're not going in, because you don't want people to say about you, you see, he's not praying. Even if you pray in a different shul, I mean, we'll see in a minute if they, whatever. If you didn't pray in one shul, don't pass by the shul when they're praying, because Ve'item Nekiim, Me'ashiv, Me'Yisrael. Good? We'll continue next week. בעזרת השם.
Thank you.
זכה
ברוך. זכה ברוך. רבי חיים בן אבישי אומר, רק סוג לא יוזר, לפיכך, כבר עם דומה זו שנאמר, אדוני, חפש מה זו יתורה ביד.